One wonderful thing about being pregnant and working for Studio 10 is that we love our treats here. Mm. We love a bit of a sugar hit. Here's proof.
Are you ready? It's as many cookies as you can handle. Three, two, one, and go.
How different does Joe look after his makeover? Now, the Cookie Monster would be salivating if he knew what we are about to do. Mm. She is the head chef at one of the Big Apple's favourite bakeries where New Yorkers can indulge their sweet tooth. It's called Momofuku Milk Bar. Please welcome Christina Tosi to Studio 10.
Thank you.
Yum. Now, here in Australia, we call cookies biscuits. What is the difference between a cookie and a biscuit?
Well, in the States, a biscuit is like a scone or a savoury, buttery, fluffy, baked good that you eat with fried chicken and gravy.
Oh,
so a biscuit
savory
in the States is not like a beautiful, sweet, buttery, fudgy masterpiece. That's what a cookie is.
Now, I love my sugar. I love something sweet. I don't like to cook, but show me what I need to do.
Okay, so I brought a recipe that we're actually serving tonight at as part of Good Food Month at the Night Noodle Market down in Hyde Park. It goes on for the end of the month and then Melbourne next month. Mm-hmm. And I created a cookie very specially for the event with the Singleton. It's called the Singleton Whisky and Maple Cookie. So it's a little bit of a mashup.
Yummy.
Nothing that we do at Milk Bar is ordinary. Everything is extraordinary. So
these aren't really suitable for kids. It's more of an adult cookie.
It's a little bit more of a grown-up cookie, but it still has a really like fun, young, youthful vibe.
And maybe you could put chalky chips in instead of the whiskey.
You can absolutely mash this up. So for me, all good cookies start with really great butter. Mm-hmm. So Jess, you're suited up.
Yep, ready to go.
Get a little messy with me, so we're going to put that butter into the bowl of the stand mixer.
Oh, okay, in there.
All the way in. There you go. Do a lot of baking at home?
Oodles.
Oodles? Yes. Yeah. You look like a real pro to me.
Comfortable she is.
You have me fooled 100%. So every good cookie or biscuit has really great butter and then sugar. I like to use a mixture of regular sugar and
so you got brown and white sugar in there.
Yeah, it gives a nice balance of flavor, which is really important because the Singleton whiskey is also really balanced.
Okay.
So we get those going. You crack an egg.
Oh, great!
Do
a one-handed crack.
Straight in.
Go.
No eggshells. It's the moment of truth.
Pro. Woo!
Pro.
Now, what else?
So, as the butter, sugars, and egg are creaming, we have, to really give flavor and personality to the cookie, we have some vanilla extract.
Is that it? The
some
vanilla?
Maple syrup.
Oh, yum.
And some
That's
of
yummy.
That Singleton
That's the vanilla.
Whiskey.
What smell of that? So we just tip it all in?
Yeah, all in.
Is that from a vanilla pod?
Yeah, it's a vanilla bean paste. And really great vanilla makes a huge difference in any cookie, whether it's a chocolate chip cookie or this really great.
And that's the maple syrup?
That's the maple syrup and then a little splash of whiskey.
Or you could put chalky chips in.
Yeah. So that gets mixed around. Super simple, right?
Yeah.
It's about measuring it out in your kitchen. And then we have the dry ingredients. So all-purpose flour, baking powder, baking soda, and a little bit of salt.
All in there?
All in, girl.
Okay, great. Oh, this is easy
this
so
is
far.
This is so easy. And it's so much more fun when you're baking with
there
a little
help.
Okay.
Do I get in control of the button?
Yeah, you get to control the button. Okay.
Okay.
All
give
right,
it a
so
little
let's get
go.
This mixing.
I got you, girl. I got this under control. You are a natural. I'll tell you what, in our kitchens at Milk Bar in New York City, our mixers are 140 quarts, so they're big enough to like take a bubble bath in. And when someone does this, it's like the most fun, amazing explosion of laughter in the kitchen. It's important to not take yourself too seriously
when you're
baking.
Yes, yes.
Nothing can go too wrong. So now that we have this dough mixed up, we'll push the button up here. And we're gonna start scooping these cookies out. Now the secret to this cookie in particular is, it looks like a standard cookie dough, right? We'll scoop them up, roll them down, and then
flatten them.
Flatten them just a little bit, and then my real secret
Here we go.
I've made a whiskey and brown sugar glaze.
Okay.
With a Singleton. And you brush just a little. You're a pro at this.
So Jono would call these breakfast biscuits.
Breakfast biscuits.
What's
that? Play-Doh.
Breakfast.
It's like Play-Doh.
It is. All right, so we're running out of time just a little bit, so you whack
so
on that glaze.
You bake them.
And do they stretch out to that big?
They do. They flatten out, they crackle a little bit at the top, which for me is a sign of a great cookie.
Would you like to taste test?
Oh, yeah.
Are we allowed to eat these ones, or are these fake? Are they real?
They're real. I would never tease you with a fake biscuit, and we brought enough cookies for everyone in the audience. And if nothing else, starting tonight through the month at the Night Noodle Market down in Hyde Park here in Sydney, you can get your own cookie and cocktail.
Oh, fantastic. Thank you so much for coming in. Christina said she's in Australia as part of Good Food Month, and she will be appearing at the Night Noodle Markets fronting the Singleton Whisky and Sugar Bar. Christina, these are divine.
Thank you so much.
Over to you, Jono.
Thank you.